Gorgeous, gorgeous girls put out their 2022. Gorgeous, gorgeous girls hope that 2022 is better than 2021 because of their strict planning. Hello friends and welcome back to my channel. My name is Katie and today is going to be an overview of all of my writing whips as well as my schedule for the next year. If you're wondering what I'm doing for the next year writing wise, here you go. Over the course of the almost 2 years I have had my channel, I have talked about a lot of projects, and I do not blame you if you cannot keep up with the absolute insanity of all of them. I know I can hardly keep up with all my projects, and I'm the one doing them, so. 2021 was a tumultuous year for writing for me personally. At least 3/4 of it were, which, let's be honest, that's the majority of the year. I rewrote a book during the first quarter of the year, which was the good part of the year. Tried several experiments, most of which failed miserably. And eventually landed on a project that I could start drafting for this year, 2022's JanuRimo, which is currently going on right now. So, in an effort to stop a yearly slump from happening and basically derailing all of my writing plans for, like, 9 months, I've decided that I'm going to try to schedule out my year. I know, scheduling, crazy. Me? Scheduling what? Obviously, this is a rough schedule that could change throughout the year if other things come up. But for right now, sitting here staring out into the vast blank slate that is 2022, this is the plan. But first, we need to talk about all the projects. So if you ever need a refresher on any of my writing or any of my whips, here you go. The first category of whips is my written books, novels that are finished being written and are in various stages of revision. Because the revision never stops until it's on a bookshelf somewhere. First up, of course, my baby, The Wrath King. This is the book that I talk about the most, but I probably don't really talk about the plot of this book. It is the book that I have the most videos about, so. The Wrath King has been in the querying trenches since about August of 2021 and has generally been unsuccessful. Just as a, you know, eventually we'll have a video about that. Over the last few weeks, I've had several existential crises about The Wrath King, which is not fun, but here we are. Nobody wants to know all the details about the inner turmoil I've gone through. So just to keep it brief, I've basically been thinking about rewriting it again. Scary to say that out loud. I'm currently waiting for more outside feedback on it just to get a better sense of what I should be changing, like beyond the changes I already know I'm going to be making. There's just one stubborn POV that has never felt quite right to me. It's never quite fit perfectly. It's never been just exactly what I want. It's so annoying, but yeah, we'll see. So The Wrath King's not going out for any more queries until it is revised again. I'm still waiting for a last few couple of query responses to come back in. Maybe it'll be magic. Maybe I'll manage to get something substantial happening within the next, you know, couple of months, but not holding my breath for that. And this is kind of the plan of, like, if nothing comes of The Wrath King from the queries I've already sent out. So for right now, I'm just waiting for feedback and the last couple responses to my queries. If I ever get a response to some of them, who knows?
People just don't like answering their emails, apparently.
It's fine. We'll talk about that at a later date. If you want to know more about this project, I have many Twitter pitches, many outdated videos, including the second video I ever made, which was an all about my novel, The Wrath King Edition, which most of it's out of date, but the bones are there if you ever want to watch that video and cringe at how awkward I am in front of the camera. Not that that has changed much, but I'm just better at editing now and make myself appear more funny. And I have a beta call video from last February if you want, like, a synopsis kind of thing, or if you want an idea of what's going on in the book. The essential bare bones of it is, it's a dark, high epic fantasy with blood magic, war, and a god of death who wants his head back. That's the pitch. Next is the one that I have talked about sporadically, and I feel like a lot of people probably know about this project because I feel like I gained a lot of followers when I was talking about this project. It is Be Gay, Solve Crime, Drink Blood, which is my self-indulgent vampire novel. It is a murder mystery urban fantasy that is basically if The Alienist had a queer private detective, vampires, warlocks, and general fuckery. That's the pitch, that's the vibes. Basically watch The Alienist and then just slot in gay vampires, and that's literally it. I wrote this book in October and November of 2020 for NaNoWriMo. I wrote it in 60 days, which is actually actually insane to me. Genuinely so burned out from it that I couldn't look at it for another year. But in September, I talked about this in a chaotic writing update that I had sent the manuscript to Devesha and Wallace, my two lovely critique partners, who I talk about literally all the time. I never shut up about them. And they're going to be giving me some feedback on that at some point this year, and I'll be probably going into revisions on that. As far as books go, I don't think this needs a full rewrite, mostly because I actually outlined this book, so I feel like the plot, at least the structure of the book, is okay. There's definitely one POV that needs way more reworking than the other one. It will need a massive revision to fix all the fuckery going on within it, but I don't think it needs a rewrite in the way the Wrath King needed the rewrite, because the Wrath King was a plotless mess that didn't have an ending until I was 100,000 words in. I made a video about this work in progress during NaNoWriMo of 2020. I will leave it in the cards. I also have an entire playlist of writing blogs that I talk about this book and my writing of this book and the experience of me outlining and writing this book. So if you want to binge those, you certainly can. That's the vampire book. Next, let's get into books I am actually currently writing at the moment. There are two of them that I'm actually writing. The first one is obviously The Witch Book, which I am trying to find an actual title for, as well as like a code name title beyond just The Witch Book. I've been testing out some names, how they feel on my tongue, but like none of them have actually felt right. So, you know, we're just gonna keep it little hush hush there. This has everything but the kitchen sink. It has witches, witch hunters, a thruple, a Hunger Games like competition is going on here, sentient objects of power that have like their own, you know, way of thinking, an adventure that crosses an entire continent, betrayals, twists, and a lot of tropey romance. Does that actually give you anything about the book? No, but I'll be making an all about my novel video for this book in February, because I don't have the mental energy to edit that right now. I'm currently sitting at 25,000 words for it. I'm about halfway through. I should be more than halfway through, but you know, we're gonna hope that the live streams coming up this weekend will help me. And just in general, I'm having so much fun actually writing it. I love the characters, I love the plot, I love the twists and the turns and the fun aspects of this book. Maybe I'll tone it down in revisions, because that's what they're there for, right? Next, moving on, is my Nora Roberts ripoff, which again, I made an entire video about. I make a lot of videos about the books that I write. It's just a quick overview of them all. I know you've all been wondering when I'm gonna bring this one up. And here it is! I love this project more than anything in the entire world, except maybe my dogs. It's just so ridiculously fun. It's different than anything I've ever written before in my entire life. It gives me so much joy. It also gives me horrible anxiety for a multitude of reasons, most of which I will not be discussing A in this video, or B probably ever on the internet, because just there's a lot of things about this book that I just have a lot of anxiety about. But the more important part is I don't feel productive when I'm working on this project, so I just have this voice in the back of my head. It's like, you shouldn't be working on this. You're having A, too much fun, and B, you're never gonna publish it, so why the fuck are you working on it? It's great. Great little voice. I'm currently sitting at 14,000 words, and I've been tinkering with it for a while, since back in October or September, whenever I'm in the mood. It's a murder mystery thriller romance that basically stolen from Nora Roberts' Angels Fall. Like, not the characters, but the entire plot, the killer, the motivations, all of that, ripped directly from the movie version of Angels Fall, because I've never actually read the book. Thanks, Nora! I haven't spoiled the entire plotline and story of this in an entire video if you want to go watch that, since this will never be published. I'm basically doing a this book is for October, except for with Gay Murder Town. Anyway, says what it is on the tin. Gay Murder Town. It's fun, but again, will never be published. And so I guess we might as well just get this part over with, but the book that's on hiatus, The Eclipse Project. This book is hard to talk about for a multitude of reasons. I have a plan in my head of what I want to do with this, but I don't know when I will get back to it. I don't think I'm brave enough to do the work that needs to be done to make this book writable at this moment. This book is such a large book that's hard to swallow for me. There's so many moving pieces that I feel like are in my head. I can't understand. This is like getting into my perfectionist tendencies. Basically, when I start to write the first draft, I'm just so aware of all the things that need to be changed with it. And since it is so large, the idea of writing a very large book and then having to revise it is very scary to me. And the fact that I just, up until recently, couldn't find a way to fit everything that I wanted to fit into it into multiple books. Like, I want it to be a long series. I don't want it to be a duology. I want it to be like four or five books. And I just couldn't figure out how to do that. It's very hard to describe, but I'm going to attempt anyway, has an interdimensional void, eating half of a country and turning people into soulless zombies, elemental slash seasonal type of magic, a bachelorette type plot with a princess, a mentor coming out of retirement to teach children, and by children I mean like 17-year-olds that the government wants to send in to basically like suicide mission destroy the void that's eating things, you know, that one. A soldier turned hippie with some art themes going on there, maybe an art heist at some point. Like, there's just so much in the world of it and within the entire scope of what I have planned for the books that it's very, very difficult for me to wrap my head around. And I don't think I'm gonna touch this book for a while because of that. I think it would be similar to how Susan Dennard has plotted out and structured her Witchland books, where essentially each book focuses in on one main character and is their character development, but you still have the other points of view kind of surrounding it and moving forward in the plot. Coming about this in a character arc way would be a lot better than trying to do it from a plot standpoint. But again, it's not happening right now. It just needs to be gently put on a shelf for a time when I feel like I can handle it again. It's just a book that I don't think I'm good enough to write yet. And I think I just need more time to grow in my craft and grow in my writing and grow in my abilities and such. So I'm so sorry, my darling project just isn't ready. I do have an all about my novel video for it if you're interested in learning more and hearing me ramble about craft about it, because I ramble a lot about aesthetics and themes and music and stuff in that video. So if you want to watch that and learn more about the project that is not going to be happening for a while. So basically I probably won't be mentioning the Eclipse project for a while. This might be the last time I talk about it for a very long time. So I'm sorry, my baby. RIP, me to shreds. Okay, now that that whole unpleasantness with talking about the Eclipse project is out of the way, it's time for my fun projects that are in development and brainstorming. Woo! We love the colorful amorphous blobs of stories that live in our heads. So yeah, this is the random stories that I'm brainstorming, working on, that I've talked about a little bit. Not a lot, just a little bit. I might be talking about them more as we go on this year. I'm terrible at winking. I don't know why I wink so much in my damn videos. So first we have the Dragon Book, my brain rot project that won't leave me alone ever since I accidentally watched an Alt Shift X video and got like inspired by this one plot point that's in the Game of Thrones books, but like not actually. It's hard to explain. I'm excited for this one. I have all the pieces, I feel like. It just has like all the ingredients are ready to be combined into like, not into book form yet. I'm not ready to write it, but like I'm ready to like dive into actually getting the nitty gritty done. Especially because this book needs a lot of research. It's a big thick book with lots of topics, different than my usual fantasy where I have to do a lot of like mental world building. This I'm gonna actually be taking like scientific concepts and like engineering things. I'm like, I kinda gotta figure that shit out, because this leans way more sci-fi than it does fantasy. It's a thorough genre blend of sci-fi and fantasy and I am obsessed with it. My comp titles are Pacific Rim meets Aragon meets The Dig. Which I know you're probably thinking, what the fuck is The Dig? If you know what The Dig is, you're thinking, how the fuck do you get Pacific Rim and Aragon with that? Anyway, that's a whole other topic for a whole other story. It's a lot. It's a lot, but I'm obsessed. I'm ready. I'm ready for it. I'm just like ready, really ready to work on this book. The first book I'm planning on being more of like an academy school book as opposed to like, you know, full on, we're just dragon riding out of the gate. It'll be more the vibes of like Dead Poets Society, Dark Academia, minus the aspect of Dead Poets Society. That's the vibes we're looking at. This book is very character driven, which a lot of my books I think looking back are, but I don't have any like concrete crazy plot that I think the book's gonna be following. I have more character moments, character ideas. Basically in December, I accidentally started writing down all of the tropes that I want to include in this book, and I will read the vibes to you now so you can kind of fully understand what vibes we're going into this book with. So I have notes that I took when I was thinking about this book after I got my brainworm. So, no particular order. The Dragon Book vibes include queer found family, because why not? Grumpy ex Grumpy, not Grumpy ex Sunshine. Gifted Kid Burnout trademark. Dragons that definitely read more eldritch than God. Dancing as intimacy. Two bros chilling in a hot tub 5 feet apart because they're not gay. Let me experiment on you because you are literally the only one that's crazier than I am. Also, with that one, bullying as flirting, you need to be less sheltered, let me help you, and let's get drunk together and accidentally fall in love, and massages while having deep conversations. That's all I got for the Dragon Book beyond like the actual plot aspect, the stuff that I'm gonna have to research, those are the vibes for the Dragon book, if you were wondering. Next are two projects that I don't think I've ever talked about, like, in a video, but I know I've mentioned on live streams, and I've probably mentioned offhand to other people at different times. This one I know I haven't mentioned, like, hardly at all. I may have mentioned it, like, three times, and I'm not even sure I was live when I mentioned them three times, because I think I mentioned them when I was backstage on StreamYard, but for the sake of the schedule later, I have to mention it now. And this is simply called The Demon Book. Again, very creative with the titles for projects that I come up with. The Dragon Book, The Demon Book, The Witch Book, just, you know, it's fine. This book series is inspired by Greek mythology, and specifically the first one is Hades Persephone. It's enemies to lovers, bodyguard trope, urban fantasy, and mafia-like societal structure, demons and other monstrous things, demon hunting, you know, a little shadow huntery. And did I mention it was sapphic? Because it is. And here's the vibe. I don't have any specific vibes, just a Pinterest board, so here you go. Enjoy. And finally, the last project that is in development at this moment in time is what I'm calling Fantasy Bridgerton, which is exactly what it says on the tin. It's Fantasy Bridgerton. Who knew? I've literally mentioned this once. Once. I mentioned it once. And yet here I am thinking about it constantly. I know this isn't an original concept, but I have had an idea for a family in my head for a very long time. It is theoretically 8 books over 13 years. Yes, you did hear that correctly. 13 years. Oldest sibling to youngest sibling, with cousins and half-siblings. Included. And I have an idea for each of the books, the tropes that I want to employ in those. It's an aristocratic family with magical elements, lots of siblings, lots of family drama, lots of romance. Of course, it's majority romance. Like, that's what it would be. It would be like Bridgerton and the fact that it is a romance, each book having a main character that is finding their romantic partner and is going through their love life and such. Mischief, mayhem, lots of family dynamics, and a lot of diversity that I've already planned out. So I've tinkered with the tropes that I'd want to include in each book. And I wouldn't want to outline each of the books before I actually started writing any of them. So this is one of the projects that I feel like is just gonna stew on the side for a while. There's no big bad, there's no war. It's more of a romantic political drama than a, you know, Lord of the Rings. So it's totally different, tonally, style-wise, like plot-wise, things like that, because it's a majority of romance as opposed to a fantasy with romantic subplots. So it'll be very different than the other things that I write. It's very, you know, light, fluffy. Romance. It's romance. What else can I say? I just want to write romance all the time. So those are all the books that I currently have in development and have written and working on and revision and all those kinds of things. So now I'm gonna get into my tentative 2022 schedule that I've mapped out for my own sanity in an effort to chain my brain into healthy productivity patterns. See how it works. I don't know, actually. I basically just want to spend less time spinning my goddamn wheels, because I spent a lot of 2021 doing that. So first up, obviously, is January, which is Januarimo, where I'm trying to get 50k in the witch book. I feel like we all know this. Unsurprisingly, February and March, I'm also gonna be working on the witch book. I wanna finish the first draft of the witch book, which I'm thinking will be 125,000 words. So I have roughly 75k to go, which leads me to about 1,200 words every single day, which I feel like is doable for me. So I'm gonna be trying to get just the book done, trying to get the first draft done so I can let it rest for the rest of the year. And that leads us into April, where I'm gonna be doing Vita, which is a video every single day in April. But it coincides with Camp Nano, and for Camp Nano, I'm going to be working on world building and developing and researching the Dragon Book, because that's the brainworm smacked me in the face, so that's what we're doing. In May through August, it's going to be revision time. So depending on the feedback that I get, and depending on whether I want to put the Wrath King down for a while, maybe forever, who knows, I'm going to be either working on the Wrath King or Be Gay, Solve Crime, Drink Blood, and then seeking out some betas, maybe getting some feedback that way, and then maybe doing another revision depending on how fast all of this moves. Who knows? I don't actually know, but May through August is revision months. And then there are two options for September to December. I have a drafting version, which is kind of the one I want to do, but I kind of need to like actually revise shit to like, you know, can't just draft all the time. So Preptober and Nano, as well as the 2 months on either side, would be devoted to getting ready to draft the Dragon Book. Writing draft one of the Dragon Book, hopefully, if Vita goes well. It's all kind of dependent on that. That's the drafting option. But I also have September to December, a revising part two, Electric Boogaloo, where I would revise the Witch Book into a draft two, so I could then send it off to, you know, my critique partners and such at the beginning of January 2023. 2023. scary. Wow, thinking about that's weird. So yeah, that's my yearly plan. I do have a bonus month though, July, Camp Nano, where I would brainstorm slash do yet another veg. Maybe, like maybe not a video every day, it depends on how Vita goes, but essentially that style where I brainstorm, world build, and research into the project, and I would either do the Demon Book or Fantasy Bridgerton. That's the bonus month for July. I would take a break in between the May to August timeline, maybe to give the book rest, maybe because I finished, who actually knows? I certainly don't. We'll see how this year goes. But yeah, those are all the 12 months of scheduling that I have. And also now you know all the projects I'll be working on, maybe I'll make All About My Novel videos about them when I know more about them. So yeah, that is my schedule. It helped my brain a lot when I was kind of despairing over what I was going to be doing this year. It can be scary not having a plan, and I definitely didn't have a plan for after I finished The Wrath King in 2021, which I think kind of caused the downhill slide for the majority of the rest of the year. So I'm hoping that I'm on more solid ground this time around and I won't fall into a slump like I did before, because I don't like that. It was not fun. I don't recommend it. Let me know what your plans are for 2022, what you're going to be doing. Let me know some spoilers about your project if you want to, or not. Do whatever you want in the comments. If you enjoy this kind of content and me being narcissistic on main, you can like this video so it lets me know that you enjoy this kind of content and want to see more of it. And if you want to see more of my rambling face, you can subscribe. I post new videos every single week and occasionally do vlogs, even though my life's really boring. So I gotta go. I'll see y'all later. Bye! I found somebody, I say you don't cross my mind. And she doesn't know that.